Hey everybody, it is Brenda Edelman. We are on day 16 of forgiveness with Brenda. Oh my gosh, yes, it's been 16 days. Thank you to those of you who have been following up and following through. Hey, I think I see Karen. How are you? Awesome to see you. It's crazy weather here, just pouring rain, and we're going to have it for days, I believe. Hi, I've been so busy this morning, and I'm so happy to come here and get grounded and centered in truth and sharing about forgiveness, which I'm so passionate about, and applying these very tools that I'm teaching you guys to areas of my own life. It's beautiful there. Oh, good. Karen's in Florida. That's wonderful. Yeah, I'll be very happy when we start getting some sun again eventually. So yes, I've been working on two things. I'm actually working on a program where I am helping mostly entrepreneurs, also just some people who are, well, bringing their small businesses that are in person online, and also people who want to look good, feel good online. That is my video program that I'll be in all weekend. It's going to be a video makeover party. I interviewed my colleague, my friend, and my client Martine this morning on my Brenda Edelman page. For any of you who are interested in getting some help on how to be confident on video and get the skills you need, hop on over to Brenda Edelman and take a look at the three videos I did with Martine the last few days. You are a natural beauty. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. You know what I do? I take really good care of myself. It's so funny. I was going to post a picture because I've had to do forgiveness work around my inner teenager. Let's see if I'm brave enough to do it at some point in maybe in the video course. You know, I was very, very overweight as a teenager. I had really, really low self-esteem, and I had to do a lot of forgiveness work. And I actually believe that forgiveness work, when you actually do it, forgiveness of yourself and forgiveness of others, it helps with how you show up. Like, we have less lines on our face. I think. I know there's genetics and stuff like that. But I also know how I used to look when I wasn't doing this work and how I look now. And it's like literally like a lighter energy than I used to have. So thank you. I appreciate that very much. I certainly did not own that when I was younger. Thank you. Thank you for the hearts. Awesome. Okay. So it's why I teach people how to do video because, well, I'm an actress, but also I, you know, in a lot of ways, I feel like as I've aged and I've gotten more wisdom and I've done more inner work, then I'm able to show up as myself and not have to apologize, although I do apologize for my hair occasionally. Okay, let's get on with this focus, which is about forgiveness, but I had to do so much forgiveness of myself. And, you know, the whole thing with videos, you know what? This week, this month, these 30 days of forgiveness with Brenda have been, the first week was all about self-forgiveness. The second week was on forgiving your mother, forgiving the feminine. The third week, this week, is about forgiving God. Next week is forgiving God. This is forgiving your father. And we're on day two of this week's training. Yesterday was about identifying your judgments of your father or the masculine, and today is about owning projections. All the lessons are delivered to your inbox, so there's still time to sign up. When you sign up today, I don't have the link here, but it's on my Forgiveness and Freedom page, and it has gift in the line, and it's Phoenix Rising. I have put my program Phoenix Rising, which is usually for sale for free, and I've put the lessons into an email sequence, so whoever signs up for them gets them for free this month. If you sign up now, it's the third week, but you'll get the lessons from forgiving your father because each day's lesson has the lesson of the theme in it. So you'll catch up and you'll get all the lessons. They are all in a sequential order so that yesterday was identifying the judgments. Today is looking at the projections. I'm going to go a little bit into it, not the lesson because that's in the inbox. But I'm going to go a little into it. And the reason I decided to not only gift you guys that program and get these techniques into your hands, but also to do the live streams is because of the nature of this world right now. And that it's interesting that I just recently decided that I'm going to do this video course for my friends, my colleagues, my clients, to feel comfortable and skilled on video. And it is directly related to forgiveness work as well. I didn't even see the connection, because usually when I'm doing the video teaching, I'm teaching more from an acting perspective. But when I do my storytelling teaching, I teach about forgiveness. So the video will also be about forgiving those parts of you that feel like you look bad on video and that you shouldn't be showing up. It's not, it's about us, it's about deservability beyond what looks we have or how much we weigh or how old we are, or how young we are, or how good looking we are, or how unique looking we are. Not showing up, especially during this time when we're socially isolated, where the only place really to connect is on video, is a deservability thing. And so with my training, this weekend is going to be amazing because I'm going to be able to customize my training to each person. But I also have free training on my Brenda Adelman page right now. I interviewed Martine, who's going to be in this weekend's program, on 3 days. There's 3 videos there. We just finished one this morning, and there's tons of teaching in there for you to just take it, see what colors to wear, see how to express yourself so that you're yourself and you're not like all awkward because you're on video. And then if you join me this weekend, I'll be able to customize the teaching to you as well. So go to Brenda Adelman if that's something that you deal with. I didn't plan on talking about it, but it's the truth is, since we're talking about forgiveness, it applies. Because we want to forgive any part of ourselves that feels like we shouldn't be showing up or we shouldn't be seen, or that if some hater says some nasty comment that we take it on like it's ours. It's not. It's theirs. It's theirs. I almost didn't start talking about my story, which I've been talking about for over a decade on stages, been paid well, traveled, like really had dreams come true. I almost didn't speak about it because I was so afraid of judgment from others. Thank God I got over that and worked through it with the tools that I know and I teach, because so many people have been taught my story around forgiving the unforgivable and how freeing that is, because my show on stages is also about forgiveness. So yeah, this is really important, this forgiveness. And right now, getting on video is really important so that you can feel comfortable, even if you don't have a business, but you know, want to look good, feel good. And yes, we have who we are, but, you know, as someone that comes from an acting background, why not just do a few things that make it easier for you, so you're not worrying about what you look like. And also, if you are in business, it will help people gravitate towards you because you just are doing the basics that make you feel better, so then you can feel more like yourself. You know what I'm saying? It's like one less thing to think about. And then the forgiveness around this, since this is applicable today, would be, what is it inside me that feels like I can't show up, that feels like I shouldn't have a voice, that feels like it's not okay for me to talk my truth, that feels like someone's going to judge me, and then forgiving that. And for those of you who signed up for this and got all the self-forgiveness work from the first week, use those techniques. And for those of you who are in my freedom circle, we can continue to work on this because we tweak everything to what we're working on in this moment. Karen, thank you for sharing your huge breakthroughs, like freaking huge breakthroughs, in the container of the Freedom Circle, which is my very low-cost way to have a container for sharing about what's really going on and pushing through resistance, getting coaching, and having huge breakthroughs, like talking about what we're talking about all month on here, but in a private place, so that while I do preach, speak your truth, baby, I also say know who you're talking to, right? So I'm not going to talk about something that I know is going, it's like know your audience. I'm not going to talk about something that I know is people aren't going to be able to listen to because they're in defensive mode. Like, know who you're talking to. If you're talking your truth, you're usually okay, right? But there are some personal things I would never share in public because that's discernment. That's why I have private groups. That's why I hold private groups for my clients, and it's why I have coaches and I'm in private masterminds and things like that. Okay? So I have 2 ways for you to work with me privately if you want more help, and that's in the Freedom Circle, which I'll put a link in here somewhere, but it's also on my Forgiveness and Freedom page. That's specifically on forgiveness work. That's a monthly program. And then I have the video program that I'm doing this weekend. Super excited. When you sign up today, I'm actually not only gifting you, like there's so much in there, but I decided today that if you sign up today on the beta price, which saves you $100, you'll also be able to join me next weekend as well. That's if you join this weekend. Okay. Forgiving your father. Yesterday was about identifying your judgments. And again, if you have any comments, let me know. You have any questions, let me know. Tell me where you're from. Say hello if you're here because I can't see everybody. If you're on a replay, let me know you're on the replay. Yesterday was about forgiving the judgments of your father, or I'm sorry, really identifying your judgments of your father. This is probably my most, my most powerful week. They're all powerful, but this one is something I can really speak to. Like of all the focus, I have done self-forgiveness. I have done forgiving your mother. I have done forgiving God, but forgiving your father was what freed me from everything. So look at your life and see what theme for you is the biggest thing that you need to work on first that will unlock everything else. My father shot and killed my mother in 1995 and married her sister. That was the catalyst for everything. It was the catalyst for my life not being how it was. It was one way before he murdered my mother. It was another way after he did. And then he married my aunt. Lots of betrayal, lots of feeling like a victim, lots of being in shock, lots of being in depression until I wasn't anymore. And it was because of the tools that I teach you here and the tools I have been teaching since 2005. Because once it was unlocked for me, I needed to share it with other people. It's why I'm sharing this for free right now. I have a Kindle book. I have really this Phoenix Rising program, which is now 30 Days of Forgiveness with Brenda. It will be a paid program that you can join later on. I have the Freedom Circle, so that's a low-cost way of having continuity and help with me, support with me. And I also speak about this so much because it was only in forgiving my need to punish my father, the need for me to get justice. It was only in me forgiving, letting go, releasing the anger I had inside of me toward him that I had freedom. I also took him to court for wrongful death, so I teach forgiveness with setting healthy boundaries, not getting walked all over. Okay, yesterday was about identifying judgments. You have to bring everything out into the light of awareness in order to heal it. If you just compartmentalize, and I talked about compartmentalizing yesterday, if you just compartmentalize and put it to the side and you're like, no, it's okay, I've got it, it will show up in other areas of your life, either as addictions, as isolation, as not letting people close to you. One of the ways it showed up for me when I was trying to just cope with what had happened and just kind of going into like a spiritual bypass, compartmentalizing and being like, well, to survive, I just have to go on, is that in my dark moments when I'm on my own to myself and I'm privy to, I work one-on-one with clients too, I'm privy to what goes on in people's minds. For me, I wanted to kill my father. Like, I was so angry. But because I had that thought, and it wasn't conscious at the time, it wasn't conscious as far as me looking at it, knowing that that was just my anger expressing itself, I felt like an ugly human being to have that level of anger. And when we feel ugly, we don't want to be seen, so we create distance and isolation. We create other people who live as victims to their lives. So that's why this is so important to bring this up out into the light of conscious awareness, practice the forgiveness of judgments that I have been teaching for the last few weeks in this course for free right now. We'll go back up on sale when this is done. There's like another week and a half. Right now you can get these tools. Certainly you can get forgiving your father, forgiving God for free. And I'm going to be on the live streams every day with you as well. We're on day 16, so what is that, like another 14 days? I think there's actually 31 exercises in the full course, so I think it's another 17 days. Okay. Today is about projection, was about projections. Yesterday was about identifying the judgments. Today was about projections. So projections are basically where we're denying something within ourselves, but we're seeing it in other people, and we're seeing it in other people a lot usually. So my example today would be, let's see, Karen says, oh, this is big. I didn't realize isolation was part of it. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. It's so great because this is like your third time going over this material and you're getting new things all the time. It reminds me of like when I wrote my one woman show the first time, there was one ending. And then as I took time off and I did the inner work, then I rewrote the show as I rewrote my life to be better, higher vibration. Yes, isolation's a big part of it if we feel judgment against ourselves because of what we're thinking, right? Okay. If we're afraid to be seen, and listen, I'm never saying just be vulnerable and be seen by everyone and tell someone who is gonna like basically shit on you or be defensive, tell them your deepest, darkest secrets. You don't wanna do that because then that just makes everything worse. You want to love yourself so much and hold yourself in the vulnerability that then you also only invite people into your life that you're going to share at this level with that love themselves enough that they wouldn't be putting you down. They would be holding you with compassion. Okay, so projections, again, the lessons are in your inbox, but for today, for the little crib notes here in the live stream. So, for on isolation, everything like that. So, let's say way back, let's say 1998 or something, when after my mom died and I was hating on myself, not outwardly, but I was feeling ugly for my dark thoughts and my anger. And I was meeting, and I had broken up with my fiance, and I was starting to date again. And I was meeting men that were emotionally unavailable. Really emotionally unavailable. That was a projection because I was emotionally unavailable. So I would meet all these people, but it's like the ego does not want to accept that we have these qualities that we're seeing all around us. But if you're seeing these qualities all around you, often you're either denying the quality within yourself. What's the other thing? You're denying it and disassociating. So, for example, I wanted to feel like I was a good person. All these men were emotionally unavailable, but the truth was I was emotionally unavailable. Huge insight for me. And when I realized that, for me, I did a lot of inner child's work so that I, Brenda, could start to trust myself and my inner child could trust that I wasn't going to choose somebody who was emotionally unavailable, emotionally cold, things like that. Ask me if you have any questions. I had to own it. I had to own that. I had to own that what I was seeing in other people around me was present in me. I had just disassociated from it. And that's healthier to integrate. Never to beat yourself up, but forgive yourself. Right? My stuff is all about forgiveness. Okay. So tomorrow's going to be about reframing. Oh no, tomorrow's going to be about taking radical responsibility. That's in the lesson that goes to your inbox at 10 a.m. every morning. You're getting a lesson 10 a.m. when you sign up. Then the next day is going to be reframing judgments, seeing how they serve you, how they can serve you, or how you can take a step forward. The next day is actually going to be an introduction to Ho'oponopono, the Hawaiian forgiveness prayer. And then I'm going to do another training on healthy boundaries. I did this last week regarding judgments against your mother and then setting healthy boundaries with the feminine or your mother. And then we'll have another day of self-care before we move into forgiving God. Karen says, "Oh snap. Yes, I'm realizing I'm unavailable when I call it out in him." Good. I'm glad you showed up for this because it's amazing how many insights can happen when you're doing this work live and when you're doing it with someone who can hold and has done, and I continue to do an incredible amount of work to see where I am unhealed, where I can apply loving to those parts inside that hurt, you know? Look at that. I've got something on my chair. Okay, that's it for today. That is the training, the extra training. Let me know if you have any questions. Let me know if you need any guidance on how to, you know, work through some of this. Karen, you're in our private group, so you can write me in there and I can give you some very specific feedback because I know you. And for those of you who would want to work with me in a group level, that would be in the Freedom Circle. And I'm available for one-on-one as well. For those of you who want to be on video like I'm on video right now. You've got a message to share. Maybe you want to reach out to your clients. I invite you to join me in the virtual video weekend retreat, which is starting tomorrow. I'm ridiculously excited about that. It's going to be a coming together for community, creativity, prayer, and skills. You're going to learn mad skills on how to be better on video. That's my goal, so that you can, you know, create online courses, but not do blah, blah presentations. Actually bring your personality in. Yeah, that's pretty exciting. Someone who just joined is working on his own online video pro course, and he didn't want to just be blah in his videos. He wanted to be fantastic and use his personality, right? Because we all have these personalities in person. Then we get on video and we're like, meh, meh. It's like, you can actually be yourself and people will be excited about that and what you have to say. Okay. That's all I got today. Have a beautiful rest of your day. If you know anybody who could use a jolt of forgiveness, please invite them to this page, Forgiveness and Freedom. If you know any business people who are struggling because they're not getting online, usually they don't say they're struggling, they're just not getting on video. Send them to my page, Brenda Adelman. I've got some really great training on there in the interviews I just did with Martine, and then they'll see information on how to join the weekend retreat, which is a steal of a deal. It's the lowest I could possibly do it and still value my time, but also give you super techniques to feel confident, comfortable, and yourself on video while you're growing your business, connecting with people. Really, it's about being yourself, but the best of yourself. Let's see. Cliff says, enjoy the rest of your day, Brenda. Have a good weekend. Thank you. You too. And ciao, Karen. Thanks for the heart. Thank you to whoever else is here. Vicky, Linda. So nice to see you all. And for those of you watching the replay, please say hi. Let me know if you have any questions. Tag me so I don't miss them. Okay, bye.